Hello friends, let us discuss a very important topic, cytoskeleton and molecular motors. After watching this video, you should be able to understand the role of cytoskeleton and molecular motors. You should differentiate three types of cytoskeleton: drugs acting on cytoskeletal elements, pathological basis of disorders associated with these, and the interaction between molecular motors and cytoskeleton. Okay. Cytoskeleton is a cellular structure that helps in maintenance of shape and internal organization. For example, see, you know that cell membrane is fluid, okay, lipid bilayer is having fluidity property. But when you stand up from sitting position, all your cells are not going down, okay. Muscles have a skeleton, right? See, muscle, they have a support, bone, okay? Otherwise, we cannot stand up. In the same way, this cytoskeleton, it is a skeleton for cells, okay? It is there. These are protein elements, okay? They are maintaining the shape of cells, clear? It also provides mechanical support that enables cell to carry out functions like cell division, transport of molecules, all this is done by cytoskeleton. There are three classes of cytoskeleton: microfilaments, intermediate filaments, and microtubules. Actin is a microfilament. Okay. Tubulin, as the name suggests, microtubules. Intermediate filaments, you can see that their size is intermediate. Actin, that is microfilament, is the thinnest one. Microtubule is the largest one. Intermediate filaments, intermediate in the size. And intermediate filaments are heterogeneous. See, lamin, keratin, vimentin, desmin, neurofilament, there are so many proteins. Okay. Let's begin with microfilaments. That is your actin. There are two types of actin: alpha, beta, there is another also gamma actin. This actin exists in two forms, globular and filamentous, G actin, F actin. Okay. Globular actin polymerizes to produce filamentous actin. This polymerization requires magnesium, ATP, all these things. Okay. This F actin is the one we see in images, like we see, right, beaded structures, right? So this is your F actin, filamentous actin. See this. So, actin molecule continuously associate and dissociate to form this filament, okay, microfilament. It is the thinnest one. The end in which active association of actin molecules happens, that is this end. When ATP binds, association. When ATP is not there, otherwise ADP is there, hydrolysis happens, ADP is there, it will be dissociation. ATP association, ADP dissociation. So, the end in which ATP is there, it will be plus end, positive end. Okay. The end in which dissociation happens because of ADP, that will be your minus end. So, these microfilaments, they have a polarity. Remember this. They have a polarity, plus end and minus end. Clear? The ATP, I told you, right, ATP binds to actin. The ATP binding fold, domain of actin, is known as actin fold. Okay. So, this domain should present only in actin, right? It is your logic. But nature does not work in that way. Nature always preserves particular domains. This ATP binding domain is also present in hexokinase, which is a glycolytic enzyme. It is also present in a chaperone protein, HSC 70, heat shock protein 70. See, these are all different enzymes, but they share the common domain. This is the beauty of nature. Actin is a component of thin filament. Okay, in muscles we studied, right, thin filament, thick filament, all these. So, actin forms the thin filament. Okay, actin is involved in muscle contraction along with myosin. And these microfilaments, they help in the changing the shape of cells. For example, amoeboid movement of phagocytes is due to pseudopodia formation. Okay. During mitosis, okay, let me show you. After mitosis, what will happen? The two cells will be for a brief period of time connected with actomyosin complex. This is known as contractile ring. Okay. This contractile ring is due to actomyosin. Okay. This is some of the role of microfilaments. Let's go to microtubules. Microfilaments, they are like filaments, okay, they are all solid, okay, but microtubules, tubules, they are hollow tubes, okay, tubules, hollow. There are two tubulin proteins, alpha, beta. They form a heterodimer and they will again associate, okay, multiple, at least 13 will arrange to form what? A hollow structure, microtubules. These are the largest. There are two types, alpha, beta. They form hollow. This hollow shape is the one which is responsible for the mechanical strength. Okay. If you compress, because it is hollow, it won't break. If something is not hollow, it will break. Okay. So, this hollow shape bears the stress. Clear? And microtubules, they radiate through each and every corner of the cell. You can see that this is the cultured HeLa cells, okay. Microtubules are in magenta color, okay. DNA is in cyan color. So, you see, they are going to the each and every corner, okay. So, they provide the mechanical strength, okay. Not only mechanical strength, we will see in the molecular motor portion, what is the other role of microtubules. Mitotic spindle, see. Formation of mitotic spindle involves microtubules. Okay. Microtubule inhibitors are used in cancer. Okay. Vinca alkaloids and taxanes. Vincristin, vinblastin. Okay. These are vinca alkaloids derived from plants. Taxanes, these are all anti-cancer agents. Colchicin is a compound which is used in karyotyping to cause metaphase arrest, and it will also be used in acute gouty arthritis to prevent the inflammation. Okay. The mechanism of action of vinca alkaloids and taxanes is on microtubules, but it is different. Microtubules, like microfilaments, are polar. Okay. There will be assembly and disassembly. Vinca alkaloids prevent the assembly, okay. Taxanes, they prevent disassembly. Otherwise, taxanes stabilize the microtubules. Vinca alkaloids, they destabilize the microtubules. Clear? Now, the third one, that is intermediate filament, okay, these are the intermediate in size. And they are heterogeneous. See, there are so many. Okay, keratins, vimentin, dismin, periferin. Okay, there are many types. And if you see, they are tissue specific. For example, actin, it is found in every cell. Okay, tubulin, it is found in every cell. But if you see, lamin, ABC, it will be in nuclear lamin of every cell. But if you see, glial fibrillary acidic protein, it will be limited to the nervous system, right? Okay. So, that is why we say that they are tissue specific, cells are cell type specific. For example, keratin. Keratin will be found only in the epithelial type of cells. Okay. You won't find it in the mesenchymal cells. Okay. Mesenchymal cells, they will have vimentin. Dismin will be in the muscle cell. So, they are tissue specific. Okay. And you can see that keratin. Okay, keratin is stained red, and this keratin, it gives a support to the cell. See, it is surrounding the cells. So, this gives the support to the cells. Unique features of intermediate filaments are, they are less dynamic. Actin and microtubule, they associate, disassociate, but here, there is no such thing. They are stable. They are less dynamic. They do not contain polarity. We know. And they are tissue specific. Neurofilament is present only in neurons. We have seen already. and these can be used as a markers for cancers. They help in immunophenotyping. For example, if you see keratin pearls, you know, right, this old pattern of keratin, this is known as keratin pearls. This keratin pearl is a marker for carcinoma, that is epithelial malignancy. Okay, like that, desmin, they will use for mesenchymal. Okay, diseases due to defective intermediate filaments. Epidermolysis bullosa simplex, here trivial injury will cause bullous formation. This is because of keratin 5 mutation. You know, keratin, it gives mechanical support to the cells, right? So when this is mutated, there will be dissociation of cells. Okay, Hutchison Gilford progeria. Okay, this is a prototype progeria, and here the mutation is lamin A. We will discuss this in the next slide. Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis involves defect in neutrophilaments. Let us see what is happening in the progeria. Mutation in the lamins, okay, they are important for the nuclear lamina. When there is a defective, farnesylated lamin A will accumulate, and this interfere in the ordinary functions and it causes premature aging. Okay, so if they ask you, the defect in progeria is lamins. Okay, now let's review cytoskeleton. Microfilament thinnest, intermediate microtubules is the largest, made up of alpha beta gamma actin, microtubules alpha and beta, tubulin, intermediate, there is lot of proteins. Microfilaments are beaded structure. Okay, it's like that. Okay, intermediate filaments, they form alpha helical rods that assemble into rope-like filaments. Keratin, again, there are many types of keratin. They will form heterodimers and they will form assemblies. Okay. Microtubules are hollow tubules. For intermediate filaments, there is no need for ATP, GTP and all. Okay. For other things, actin and tubulins, they require energy because they associate and disassociate. Function of cytoskeleton, giving shape, strength, providing anchorage, intracellular transport. How they help in intracellular transport? When we study molecular motors, it will be clear. Muscle contraction, in physiology, you know, actin and myosin. Beating of cilia, again, we will study molecular motor. Amoeboid movement of phagocytic cells, we have seen. Now, let's come to molecular motors. What is a motor? Motor is a mechanical device, right? So here, molecular motors are those that convert chemical energy into mechanical energy. Most of them use the energy provided by the hydrolysis of ATP. Some use GTP. What are they? We will see in the next slides. First, these molecular motors can be again classified cytoskeletal motors. That means they associated with the cytoskeleton, what we have studied. Actin, tubulin, these are the cytoskeletal elements, right? So these motors will be associated with either actin or tubulin. Okay, there are four cytoskeletal motors: myosin, kinesin, dynein, dynamin. Okay, myosin, kinesin, dynein, dynamin. Remember this, very very important. Rotary motor. Okay, here rotation is there and ATP is produced. Here what is happening? There is proton pump, there is again chemical energy, okay. Then it is converted into mechanical energy. That mechanical energy will be again converted into chemical energy, okay. So, the proton pump drives this motor, okay. And this motor generates ATP by binding change mechanism. This is FO, F1 ATPase complex, or otherwise ATP synthase. FO is not zero, it is FO because it is inhibited by, FO is inhibited by oligomycin. Okay, nucleic acid motors, they are associated with nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, DNA polymerase, topoisomerase, these are all again motor function, right? They can move along DNA and RNA. Now let us study cytoskeletal motors. I have made your job very simple, just go through this table. Myosin is a motor, so a motor has to run. Remember, rail engine, train has to go in a rail road, right? So the train is your molecular motor, railroad is your cytoskeleton, either actin or tubulin. Myosin is the motor which move along the railroad of actin. Okay, for a train to go, it needs energy, either electricity, petrol, coal. Here the energy is ATP. Okay, clear? Myosin, actin, ATP, and myosin is involved in muscle contraction and other functions. Dynamin, dynamin moves along actin, but dynamin requires GTP. All the others, they require ATP hydrolysis, it only requires GTP. Dynamin is involved in receptor mediated endocytosis. You might have studied clathrin coated pits are there, receptor mediated endocytosis happens, that is the thing. Okay, receptor along with the ligand and all, there will be endocytosis, that is receptor mediated endocytosis. Kinesin is a molecular motor which moves along tubulin. Dynein is also molecular motor which moves along tubulin. They both use ATP. Okay, these two points are same. The difference is kinesin is involved in anterograde transport. For example, there is a neurotransmitter. That neurotransmitter comes from the cell body of the neuron to the end. Okay, so that is anterograde. Dynein, beating of cilia. This is retrograde. Okay, beating of cilia is example for retrograde transport. Remember this. Now, what you are seeing is kinesin, a molecular motor which is moving along with microtubules. Kinesin is carrying a cargo. For example, it may be a neurotransmitter containing vesicle. See how beautiful the nature is. Now, what you are seeing is the structure of a flagella, okay, eukaryotic flagella. Do humans contain flagella? We know that we have cilia in respiratory tract and your urogenital tract. But where is the cilia in our, sorry, where is the flagellum in humans? The only flagellated cell in human body is sperm. Okay, remember this. Dynein, see this, the spokes of dynein is important for the maintenance of both cilia and flagellum. Whenever there is a defect in the dynein, it will affect both cilia and flagella. So, defect in dynein arm causes cartilaginous syndrome. As cilia is immotile, it is also known as immotile cilia syndrome. Okay. This syndrome is associated with situs inversus. Movement of organs itself will affected during the development. Situs inversus. And sperm, you know, sperm requires flagellum, right? So sperms won't move. So azoospermia will be there. So these people, they will be infertile. Okay. So let us summarize. Cytoskeleton is a cellular structure that helps cells maintain their shape and internal organization. There are three components: microfilament, intermediate filaments, microtubules. Actin forms microfilament. Microtubules are formed by alpha and beta tubulin. Intermediate filaments, various things. Okay, microtubule inhibitors are used in cancer. Mechanism of action of vinalkaloids and taxanes is different. Okay, intermediate filaments are less dynamic and they are cell and tissue specific. Okay, in molecular motors, we studied that they are, molecular motors are the vehicles carrying the cargo. They run upon the cytoskeletal framework. Myosin is the motor protein that move along actin filaments using the energy of ATP hydrolysis, while kinesin is the motor protein that move along tubulin using the energy of ATP hydrolysis. Dynamin is involved in receptor mediated endocytosis. It uses GTP. Okay. Primary ciliary dyskinesia, immotile cilia syndrome or cartilaginous syndrome. It's an autosomal recessive disorder due to dynein arm defect. Okay. I hope you understood this high yield concept. Thank you.